You've most likely heard it before, but what actually is MEV and how does it work? Well, MEV stands for Miner-Extractable Value, or more generally, Maximal Extractable Value. In simple terms, MEV is the total value that miners extract from a blockchain's network of users by selectively reordering, inserting, and censoring transactions within blocks produced on the network. MEV is inherently a hidden tax on users of a blockchain by miners, validators, and sequencers. So, to understand what MEV is, let's first begin with a quick overview of how blockchains work. A blockchain is simply a chain of blocks, with each chain connected one after the other, where each block is unique. Each block is like a page in a public ledger, where all the transactions are documented and visible to everyone. Pending transactions from users go to a pool called the meme pool, where a miner comes in and chooses a few transactions from the meme pool to organize into a block. But why only a few, Jamel? Okay, let me explain. Because each block has limited space and can only contain a limited number of transactions. Let's back up for a second and talk about who these miners are. In proof-of-work consensus protocols, there's a group of network participants known as miners who play a critical role in securing the network and validating transactions on the blockchain. Miners are responsible for selecting, organizing, and aggregating network transactions into blocks. It's this group of users who ultimately decide which pending transactions from the meme pool are added to the produced blocks. Okay, so as you might expect, miners and other key players such as validators and sequencers, when it comes to proof-of-stake protocols, typically prioritize the transactions which have the highest value and gas fees so that they can get the highest profits as possible, of course. It's important to understand that MEV is also not limited to just miners in proof-of-work-based blockchains. It also applies to validators in proof-of-stake networks. In proof-of-stake networks that use validators instead of miners, most of the MEV flows to the validators. Miners, like everyone else, are out to make money. It's what we do. Okay, to help this make sense to you, let's explore how MEV works in an example from the traditional finance world. Suppose an investor or trader asks a broker to purchase 100,000 shares of a company, right? Now, the broker knows that the trade of this size will push the price of the share higher. So before buying the shares for his client, the broker instead buys a certain number of shares for himself first. After all, he's in control of placing the orders, so it's his choice in which order he decides to execute them. Now, once the broker is first bought for himself, he can execute the larger order on behalf of his client. And as soon as the price of the share goes up, the broker sells the share to make a profit. This is similar in concept to how MEV allows miners to profit when they're allowed to reorder, insert, and censor transactions within the blocks being produced, all of which is legal and valid on a blockchain. Okay, let me give you the most common MEV attacks. These attacks include frontrunning, which involves getting a transaction first in line in the execution queue ahead of a known pending transaction. Sandwich attacks, a variation of frontrunning whereby a predatory trader places two transactions, one before and another right after a pending victim transaction. Backrunning, the practice of getting a transaction ordered second in line or immediately after a known pending target transaction. Liquidations, running specialized bots to monitor the network for transactions, presenting liquidation opportunities, and act to either front run or back run transactions to be the first to liquidate a loan. Time-Bandit Attacks, a type of attack only miners can execute that retroactively reorganizes blocks to capture MEV opportunities in previously mined blocks. So Jamel, why does MEV occur? Well, MEV exists on all smart contract blockchains where there's a party responsible for transaction ordering, including validators and proof-of-stake-based systems like Ethereum 2.0. It's due to the design of a blockchain network that allows miners to have such tremendous flexibility and the ability to manipulate transactions, creating an opportunity to pull additional profits from users. As long as there's a party with the ability to selectively order transactions and the incentive to maximize profits, look, MEV is going to exist. There are some underlying problems with MEV. For example, MEV is inherently a hidden tax on users of a blockchain that miners profit from at the expense of regular users. This is often in ways that may not be immediately apparent to all users until after their transaction is processed. This includes the increase of gas fees paid and additional slippage, both of which extract value directly from regular users. MEV can be benign in some cases, meaning it creates positive sum value for all participants, while in other cases, it could be bad enough to be considered theft. While it may present lucrative opportunities for miners, there are inherent issues that the average investor suffers from as a result. MEV also undermines decentralized blockchains on a fundamental level. When the reward is high enough for a particular actor, they become more incentivized to act in a selfish way that isn't beneficial for the system as a whole. The original vision and ethos for DeFi, after all, was to provide a decentralized, safe, and cost-effective method to trade and engage in financial opportunities without the need for intermediaries or third parties. So here's the question. Can MEV be solved? Inevitably, any blockchain that allows players the ability to reorder transactions allows MEV extraction opportunities to exist. So then, how can the actual issue be solved? Well, currently there's a strong divide between those who believe MEV is inevitable and those who believe it can be solved, with many attempting to combat MEV through the creation of new protocols focused on ordering transactions in a much fairer way. Hey yo, thank you for watching, and make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. If you enjoyed watching this, let us know your thoughts in the comments below.